Hi everybody, I'm back, and today I have sketched out my rose on a black pastel or a black velvet pastel paper. So and since I'm coloring on black paper, my lighting is going so funky, so I kind of had to add this whiteboard next to it, else it just flashed everything out and it just went all loopy on me. So but it, when holding my hands, it actually helps it a little bit. If I lift it up to show you guys, then you can see what happens. So yeah, this was something brand new. I never seen this. Anyways, pastels. Let us color this rose in the pastels on black paper. Like I said, I never done this before, so this will be quite fun. I approach this just like I do every rose. I'm starting to sketch or put in the darkest color. That is my shadow color. I have worked on this paper before, but never on this color of this paper. So that is so exciting. And I had to go over to make the line art with white, so you actually got to see it. So this will be fun, and I have gotten off my pan pastels because I have this shimmery set of pan pastels that I got from Darlene Cheshire Cat a year and a half back or something, and I love those colors, and I'm usually putting them on top of other thing like an accent. And I was thinking that maybe we could test that out on this paper, because that kind of should make them pop. But when I put them on my table, all of my light just flashed completely out, and that shimmer just looked like it was shiny white. So I had to take them off my table so I could pick them up again when we are going to use them. So I'm just working with some with the Cabotello and some with the Carandash pencils. That darkness did not really show that well, but okay. Because for me, pastels is I'm more for the color than anything else. So I do like all of my pastels actually for different things, like the Cabotello. I like them a little bit better for the details, and because they are kind of a medium. These Carandash ones are super soft, so they are good for like a base or a background and stuff, and they are just so creamy and soft. But for the details, they are not that good because of that. So like for like making fur or hair with the Carandash can be tricky, because they just blend out so nice. So I'm not sure quite how much you actually see because there's. I'm getting worried because if you really can't see it, then it's no point in me sitting here and making these rows. So I just got my darkest blue again and just blending that out with that little bit lighter one. And that was my dog, or one of them. I have other dogs, so I'm putting on a second layer of this medium blue color. Hopefully, you can see something now. More here. Then of course I will add that white on top of here. Slowly building the layers, going back in with the darker one. Maybe I have to sharpen my pencil now. I'm concerned because, well, hopefully it will grow out so you actually get to see it as I'm getting more and more pigment down. Probably could have pushed hard, and that is kind of not what I do it in pastels because they are so soft and kind of pastels just works for themselves really. So, maybe we should test this white out a little bit. Starting around this one. That is like that. Just push that down a little bit down into the paper. Can you see something? Oh, well, you can see the white at least. Then goes out in this one. Oh, and I'm so sorry that my phone is making these noises. I have to turn the sounds off again. So hopefully it will keep quiet now. Should not really be that white, but these edges here I do like to have to keep white. pieces. Awesome to work with. I really like to work with this. Is that? Oh no, that's not supposed to be wet. Well, I guess we have to cover it up some. Should maybe have, yeah, an even a darker one, but kind of hard when you're working on black. We will just have to see how this turns out. And see if we can't build up some colors, some white in that, or make some highlight there. And I'm sorry for moving it down, just like that. Of course, I can use tools to. I think I need to sharpen this one a little bit. Where do I have one on? So I can sharpen with this one. So there we are. Nice sharp white. And I'm happy that you or that this actually do show up on my camera. Medium color. Like that. I'm sorry for not being chatty, but this is kind of fun for me as well, and when I'm focusing, I don't really know, well, I don't know what to talk about, and I don't know actually if I could. Oh, I'm blowing. Well, you should never do that, just so that I have said that. I should soften up that line a little bit. That can use this one and blend that out a little bit, because I think that that got a hard edge. Hard edge. It is kind of late at night for me, and I'm starting to get really tired. So my English is not the best at this. Right. But I hope that you manage well, anyways. Like that. Probably should have started working in the upper left corner, since I am right-handed. But hey, it's working, so. So, I guess that then everything is okay. This usually doesn't take this long. Pastels are really a fast medium. That is one of the things I really love about it. But on this black paper, I really need it. A whole lot of layers. Of course, my camera doesn't really help me. It's being a goof like this. I will have to show you that. Pan pastels. Because those shimmery colors, they are awesome. I'm just feeding the paper with pigments here. I'm shaking the camera, and I'm so sorry. It's attached to my table, so yeah. Sometimes when I'm coloring, then it shakes. That down a little bit. That highlighter. And take that in a little bit like that. A little bit more. Because I don't want it to be striking white. Our blue rose looks to be done. If we want to add some more colors in it, of course we can blend in some purple or pinks, green, actually whatever color we want to, because this is our rose and we can decide how it actually will look like. Like that. That little leaf. Okay, so we have some greens and stuff. Oh, I have this one baroque from my tip. I will just put that on. Oops. It's kind of like a base layer. Use this yellow to tone down that white line with it. And rose leaves has this raggedy tips. This darker green here. Can add in something that looks like that did not really look like veins, but not so what, it is a leaf, so I'm sorry that you actually can't see very much of this on the camera as things are now. This darker color won't really show at all. It's something like a leaf. This hand pastels. So we have they come in a pack or a set or a pack of six. Amazing colors, and like this one. This is the light blue. I think that is gorgeous. And we have this green that I put. There is that color. It is really a pastel-y color. But I'm thinking that we should put some on, or leaf and stuff. So we need something to put on it. Let's just take this makeup brush here. So I'm just picking up some of this. Oops. Let me see if I can make this brush work for me. Seeing that Chris Art uses these ones quite a lot when she's working, but of course she's working on pastel mats, so that is a little bit different than this paper that I'm working on. I have this pastel or the soft tools for the blue color, so we can see if we can put some of that on there, at least on the tips. I can unlock the edges up here. So maybe we can make it sparkle a little bit. To follow those white outlines with this shimmery pan pastel. But you can also see that these soft tools really soften everything out. Those crispy lines that I have, or I had, they are about gone now. But as I still have a pencil, I can go and back and get them back if I feel that I need to. Now I should not blow carrot. Let's see if I can rub that off. This paper really doesn't let go of pastel easily. I think I like this. So, this you can do with any color that you would like to have. Let me see now if I can try to lift it up so you can see it a little bit better. Oh, and there it goes again. My light. This is just so weird. And look at this. They are disappearing. I have no idea why this happens. Okay, if I lift it up now so you can see it. And of course now it don't even want to focus anymore. Yeah. Well, anyways. Let me see what happens if I lift this right away. Do you see how the colors changes when I put my hands down? There. That is kind of the right true color of it. So I just find this to be so weird to have my camera and lighting and everything just changes. Like if I move up my hands now. That is just amazing. Anyways, so this, yeah, I have to hold my hands here. Zoom in on my hands. Thank you, camera. So, this is just how I would color a rose with pastels. Taking a dark color and a medium color and a white or a light color. And putting all the darkest and or the shaded areas that is toward the center of the rose, and then the lighter the further away it goes. So that was this felt and paper. I will try to find a link actually for this beard paper. It actually feels like it has fur and stuff. It's really soft and really nice. Red. Very flimsy though. But anyway, this was my rose with pastels on this vellum or velvet paper. So thank you everybody for watching, and I will see you all later, and go and put color on something. Until next time, I love you all. Dip, use your heart. Bye.